In this lesson, I will show you how to broadcast live in your app. You can display two types of live shows in your app, live radio and live video. So first, go to the add-on store and activate the service you're going to use. So let's start with live audio. I'm going to add a new section in my app called radio show. And I need to provide the stream URL for iOS and the stream URL for Android. My feed is set up. Let's have a look at the app to see the result. As you saw, I can listen to my live radio show. I can also browse the app while I'm listening to the show. And I can listen to the show even if the app is closed and I'm browsing other apps on my phone. To enable users to listen to the live on the background, be sure to have activated the audio playback option in the general settings of your app. Activate this option only and if only you're using an audio section in your app. If you're not broadcasting 24 hours per day, you can display a message when the show is not live. Turn on the scheduling option and define when the show is live. In this example, the live player will be available Monday to Friday from 9 p.m. to 11:09 p.m. and it will repeat every week like this. If you're not hosting a recurring show, turn off the repeat option and just define the starting date and the ending date of your live show. To customize the message displayed when your show is not live, go to the template of the live player and customize your message in the panel. You can click the preview button to see what will be the result. Let's have a look now at the Live Plus audio section. The ID is the same, but here the player will display meta information contained inside your feed. Let's see how it looks like inside the app. I have the current track playing. I can see the name of the artist, the name of the song, and also the image associated with the track. There is a button to go and purchase the song on the platform. So the place where the user will be directed to depends on what you've put on your feed. There is also a button to share the track on social network, and users can browse the last five played songs. The information displayed on the player is coming from your live feed. So all this information is managed on the server side, on the server where you are encoding and streaming your live radio show. Let's have a look now at the live video add-on. So let's call this section TV news. And here again, we are going to add our live streams. Let's see the result in app. With the live video add-on, you can also define time slots during which your show will be live on your phone. So just turn on the scheduling option and define your time slots. It can be one time slot or a repeating time slot throughout the day or the week. And when the show is not live, a message will be displayed on the player and you customize this message here on the panel. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time and meanwhile, happy app building.